Okay, now, this part five is video game artificial intelligence. Now, I know that with technology and stuff, I mean, they can only do so much into a game. But still, I get so extremely frustrated in games, particularly, like, especially in this game, Animal Crossing. The whole series, it suffers from this same problem. Limited artificial intelligence. Now, I just get so frustrated. Like, one of the things that frustrates me in this game, the first thing that comes to mind is, like, when you're talking to a character and they ask you about their phrase and whether it's cool or not, and then you can change it and make them say something else at the end of their sentences. That's a funny aspect of the game. It's a funny thing that you could do, and I always make them say something very embarrassing and funny. But what ticks me off about it is that the things that you make the character say isn't specific just for that character. You could walk up to another character right afterwards and suddenly they're using that same silly phrase that you made that last character say. I want each character to be individual and different. Well, why can't they just make sure it stays that way? Like, to where only that one specific character will say the funny thing that you make them say. Now, that's just one of several complaints I got about Animal Crossing. Another thing relating to artificial intelligence that always has frustrated me in games, not just Animal Crossing here, but... And once again, I know games just have limitations and they gotta be whatever way they are. But, like, when characters are so stupid that they act like they don't recognize you after they just barely got through talking to you. How you're talking to a character, then you walk out the door, you come back in that door and talk to the character, they act like they just barely saw you and they say the same things again. I totally hate that. It's that way in every single game in existence. Because a game is a game. They're not like a human that could just keep coming up with new dialogue. But I long for the day where games are so intelligent that it makes you feel like you're actually talking to another person. Like, RPGs are especially this way. How all the little characters that you could talk to, they're just dwelling in the same thing over and over. You could talk to them over and over throughout the entire game and they're still saying the same stupid phrase of speech. Oh gosh, be more intelligent for God's sakes. And even in games like, what's a good example? Paper Mario, I'll say Paper Mario. Like Super Paper Mario. You're getting the little pixel character to tell you about certain things, and she keeps saying the same things over and over and over instead of acknowledging that she already told you. And well, that might not have been the greatest example, but I'm sure you all know what I mean. It's frustrating. I want a smart game, not something that's dumb and robotic. And also, this doesn't really have to do with artificial intelligence, but something else that really frustrates me, like, particularly in Animal Crossing City Folk, which is what I'm playing right here in this video demonstration. Why the heck did Nintendo make it to where you can't put hats and glasses and other accessories over your Mii mask? That pisses me off so much I just felt like cussing Nintendo out. It's retarded. I got my cool Mii mask on and I got these really cool accessories like a Pikmin hat that I can wear and a hot dog hat and different things. And no, I can't put them over my Mii mask because it'll take the mask off and I just got the regular stupid face on with the accessory. What retards were making this game? No offense to Nintendo, but that's just retarded, man. Why couldn't they have just... I better shut up. You know, my complaints will go on and on and on. The more I think about this game, I can just keep on coming up with more. Like the fact of how the whole entire city area of this game is boring and nonsense and was definitely not worth actually naming the game after. Animal Crossing City Folk, the city part's boring. Only a couple measly stores that's even worth going to, such as Shampoodle just to get a makeover, and the expensive Gracie Grace's clothing store. That's the only two places I even care about going to. For some reason, Crazy Red doesn't even seem significant in this game, like he did in other games. And the auction house? That's totally pointless to me. And who the heck cares about getting new expressions to do and stuff? Ugh. But I guess I'm way off the subject of artificial intelligence. I just long for the day where games can become just as smart as an actual human being that you're talking to, and where there's always something new that the characters will say. They'll never repeat themselves. They'll never act like a complete retard. And also a game, also specifically about Animal Crossing, where the characters will finally do something for their own selves. Like, pull the freaking weeds! Don't leave it all up to me to pull every weed in the town. None of them even deserve to live in town. They don't even know how to do their own gardening or anything. What, I gotta do everything? I leave the game for a couple months and come back and the whole town is covered with weeds. What lazy citizens of these villages, man. Why can't somebody do their own jobs? Limitations. Eh. I hate limitations in games. Like, why do they have to limit the size that you can build your house in Animal Crossing? It's so small in Animal Crossing City Folk. I think it was even bigger in the DS version, Wild World. There was more rooms in your house and stuff, and why on earth can't they let you set items outdoors instead of only indoors? Like flags and other different things that you wouldn't see inside of a person's house. So why didn't they allow you to put them outside? What were they thinking? That's just... Oh my gosh, man. And like in the first Animal Crossing, that it was the worst for this particular reason. Every character wanting you to deliver something to some other person in town, almost every other time you talk to them. Well, oh my gosh! How hard is it? It's only a few steps away to the other person's house. Do it yourself, man! And the villages, they're not big enough. Small, dinky little villages, few little houses, not enough to do. They really need to expand on the Animal Crossing franchise. I'm not picking on Animal Crossing, I love it. It's one of my favorite Nintendo games. And because of that, I know about a lot of things in it that could be enhanced and made better. You know, even the fishing and stuff, as fun as it is, put even more fish. I mean, it's one of my favorite aspects of the game, being able to fish. They need to, like, make more points to fishing and different things that you can do with the fish. Eat the fish yourself. Cook the fish. Send fish and bugs through the mail, which the games currently don't allow you to do, to send live items, live things to... Oh, man, its possibilities are endless. And... Oh, I better shut up. I really wish that the Wii had custom soundtrack ability, too. Because wouldn't it be cool to be able to turn on your radio in your house and hear real songs that you put in the game yourself? I could talk on and on, but these videos only allow for so much, so I'm gonna zip my mouth, shut up, and end this video right here. Thank you all for watching. I tried my best to put some good video clips during this. And feel free to comment. That's why I do these videos. I'm not one of those YouTubers who make a video and never reply to comments. Those kind of people are retarded. What's the point of making a video on YouTube if you're not even going to comment? Or if you disable the ratings and comments? What the heck is the point of putting videos on there if you're going to do that? Oh well. I'll catch you all later when I think of more videos. or reviews to do, or whatever. See ya. Thanks for watching once again, like always. Take care.